today's video, I'm going to answer the most common question na nareceive ko lately, which is, do I need to attend a guidance counseling program from Commission of Filipino Overseas or yung CFO? Well, if you are someone that is traveling together with your fiancé, your husband, your wife, your girlfriend, your boyfriend, na foreign national, then the answer is yes. You need to attend this guidance counseling program and get that CFO speaker. Now, beside foreign national partner, if yung partner nyo, spouse, fiancé nyo, is a former Filipina citizen or meron siyang Filipino with dual citizenship, magpo-fall din siya sa category na to na kailangan yung mag-attend ng guidance counseling program. Now, if you are someone naman na mag-a-apply for tourist visa, or you're someone that is applying for a visit visa but will be visiting your mother, your sister, your brother, your child, your friend, then you don't need to attend this guidance counseling program. But I would advise na para na rin maging sure tayo, because I've seen na merong mga instances na kahit applying for a visa just to visit a friend, they do require that applicant or yung Pilipino na mag-apply ng guidance counseling program, and there are times na na-upload pa rin sila. So to make sure na hindi kayo ma-offload, and to make sure that that money that you buy dun sa real ticket is hindi masayang at hindi kayo magka-aberya sa mismong araw ng pag-alis nyo, it is best that you attend this guidance counseling program. Or if you wanted to be safe regarding dun sa situation nyo, if kailangan nyo ba talaga to, it is best na tawagan nyo yung Commission of Filipino Overseas just to confirm if you do need this or not. Okay, so what is this CFO guidance counseling for? So they designed this program to make people aware of anti-trafficking, also to explain more about abuses, exploitation, domestic violence, and yung mga sexual exploitation. I think this is also to make people aware dun sa mga changes and differences na mangyayari once you migrate or visit a foreign country with your foreign partner. Syempre, you as individual, you have big differences, diba? And even you get married to a person and you've been together for how many years, hindi natin masusure kung ano ba yung mga pwedeng magbago, ano ba yung mga pwedeng ma-encounter nyo na problem. But with this program, they will educate you more on the things that you can do, the people that you can contact when you're out of the Philippines. And basically, like, every education lang talaga para malaman nyo kung kailangan na nare-red flag na ba, kasi may mga signs or nagpapakita na ng abusive treatment yung partner nyo. So this guidance counseling program, once you get this, this is a lifetime certificate. So hindi nyo na kailangan kumuha every time na aalis kayo ng bansa. The only time na kailangan nyo mag-take again ng program na to is when you change passport, and then that time, iba na yung partner nyo. Let's say you have a new husband or you have a new fiancé, then you would need to attend this seminar again. So, paano nga ba makaka-attend ng guidance counseling program? This program is, you need to secure an appointment with them. Kasi without appointment, hindi kayo makakakuha nito. Lalo na limited lang yung slot na binibigay nila per session. So, they have a CFO in Manila, in Cebu, in Clark, and in Davao. If you wanted to know where to exactly set an appointment, I will have link in the description below para doon na kayo mag direct mag-set ng appointment. Again, the session will be based depending dun sa nationality or yung citizenship ng partner nyo. If your partner is a Canadian, American, Japanese, European, there are specific session for spouse or partner citizenship. So again guys, better to get an appointment early kasi there are like limited slots. For example, for Manila, there are only 15 attendees per session. And for Cebu, they only accept 12 attendees per session. So, if in, let's say, late nyo lang nalaman na kailangan nyo pala nito, and then tomorrow, paalis na kayo, you might encounter a big problem getting that appointment if hindi nyo agad siya nakuha ng maaga. So, regarding sa setting ng appointment, if ever nagkaroon ka ng approved apartment, if ever nagkaroon ka ng approved appointment and then hindi ka nag-attend, automatically cancel na yun. And you would need to set another appointment and then you maghahanap ka na naman ng available day kung kailan meron pang slot. So, lahat ng magpapa-appointment dito, kailangan nyo mag-bring ng a barcode confirmation from the GCP appointment. Again, you can get that dun sa link na nasa description below. And then you would need 2 original valid identification card with photo or ID. It can be your passport, driver license, SSS. So, lahat ng primary and secondary IDs makikita nyo sa mismong website ng CFO. I'm going to also have the link of the CFO sa description below para makita nyo kung ano-ano yung mga ID na ina-accept nila. And then, you would also need to bring your marriage certificate that is issued by PSA. If you married nyo ginawa overseas or in any other countries, the original report of marriage, kailangan i-register nyo pa rin sa Philippine Embassy or dun sa Consulate of the Department of Foreign Affairs para tanggapin dito sa Pilipinas. And then, you would need to pay a registration fee of 400 pesos. Again guys, the registration fee is just 400 compared dun sa amount ng ticket na bibilin nyo. So, it's better na apply to get this guidance counseling program kesa ma-offload kayo and masayang lang yung pinambili nyo ng ticket na libo-libo. So, it's better to be safe than sorry. So, for additional requirements, ito yung mga additional requirements for those applicants na meron ng visa or meron ng approved visa. So, you would need to bring 2 valid identification card, original valid passport, and then original valid visa, yung visa sticker na nandun na sa passport nyo. And then you would also need to bring original CFO guidance and counseling certificate. And then you would need a duly completed immigrant registration form. Everything, this registration form, lahat makikita nyo dun sa website ng CFO. And then, meron pa rin mga additional requirement and that will be based na dun sa situation nyo. Let's say you're someone na divorced or widowed or on process yung annulment. Those papers you would need to bring on the appointment para ma-explain nyo sa kanila yung situation nyo. Again guys, the seminar or yung program will last for 4 hours. And then yung last part ng session, magiging ano na to for one-on-one session. So dun yung naipapakita yung mga additional requirements nyo like yung mga divorce certificate, annulment paper, proof of residency, death certificate ng partner nyo if ever man, or certificate of family relationship. So baka extra requirements na lang to just to support kung ano yung mga statement na ilalabas nyo sa CFO. Again, everything that you will mention to them will be strictly na secure. And you don't need to worry regarding the interview, yung one-on-one interview, because basically it will questions about you and your partner. Tatanungin lang nila kayo kung paano kayo nagkakilala, how long you've been together, what are your plans, or why did you get married this early, or when do you plan to get married. So, mga question regarding your relationship with that person. And there's nothing complicated with that. You just need to be honest with your question, and hindi naman siya kailangan na mag-English ka pa doon. So, just feel at home and feel free to be able to say whatever you feel like saying to them. So, within the day, you will be able to get that CFO certificate na yun ang gagamitin nyo or ipapakita nyo sa immigration just in case na hanapan ka nilang to. Again, there are people that I feel like willing to take the risk not to attend this program kasi sabi nila, hindi naman nakalagay dyan kasi ang sabi, spouse, partner, and yes, fiancé, spouse, and partner, tapos hindi naman daw naka-indicate ang boyfriend, girlfriend. So, gusto nila, huwag na silang umattend ng program na to. Again guys, it will be all up to you. The only people to blame if ever magkaroon ka ng problem or if ever na ma-offload ka, it's because of you. Kasi nag-base ka na, okay, kasi wala namang boyfriend, girlfriend, so hindi ko na kailangan yan. Again, if in doubt, call the Commission of Filipinos Overseas directly or just to be in the safe side, just attend this seminar and then you'll be good. If the immigration asks for it, then at least you're ready. If they don't ask for it, if you're lucky like me na hindi hinanapan nitong certificate, then you're good to go. But again, it's better to be ready and be safe. So, iwasan natin ang ma-upload and attend this seminar. So, yeah, I hope that this video helped clear yung mga in doubt whether to attend this guidance counseling program or not. So, if you wanted to learn more about Schengen visa application, or if you have further questions regarding CFO, how to get an appointment and everything like that, you can have that in the description below, or you can send a direct message to my Facebook or to my email. I will have all the information below. And also, guys, feel free to join my Facebook group where I post tips, and also you can post there yung mga question nyo, and there will be a community, a lot of people that are willing to help you and give you their tips and their experience. Everything in the description. So if you like this video, which I hope you do, please do give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more upcoming videos, and I'll see you soon. Bye.